O soul, are you weary and troubled? No light in the darkness you see. There's light for a look at the Savior, and life more abundant and free. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim. In the light glory and grace, his word shall not fail you, he promised. Believe him and all will be well. Then go to a world that is dying, his perfect salvation to tell. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strange. In the light of his glory and grace, in the light of his glory and
good morning and welcome to our sanctuary service from All Saints Church in Weston in Bath. You're very welcome, whether you're part of the regular congregation or whether you're joining us from somewhere near or somewhere further away. Thank you for being with us this morning, and I pray that you will be blessed and that you will be able to connect with God through this service. Today we're thinking about Psalm 46, which is that wonderful psalm that reminds us that God is our refuge and strength, our very present help in times of trouble. And it goes on to remind us that we need to be still and know that he is God. We need to take time to be quiet and to listen to God. So today, Mark, our rector, is going to be talking to us about the psalm. We're very lucky to have Penny Lewis, who's coming to read for us. So thank you to them. My husband, Robert, is going to help me with leading the service, and he's going to lead the prayers as well. So as usual, if I read the words in yellow on the PowerPoint, please could you join in with the words in white? And we've got lots of singing to do today. But if you don't like singing and you prefer to just listen, that's absolutely fine as well. So let's begin our service. Shall we start with that great hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness, O God my Father?
Thank you. As we come into God's presence, it's good to remember who he is, our holy and awesome God. When we do things that are wrong, it makes a barrier between him and us. But he loves us, and he wants to restore our relationship with him. So let's turn to him now to ask for his forgiveness. Shall we pray together?
Almighty God, long-suffering and of great goodness, I confess to you, I confess with my whole heart, my neglect and forgetfulness of your commandments, my wrongdoing, thinking and speaking, the hurts I have done to others, and the good I have left undone. O God, forgive me, for I have sinned against you, and raise me to newness of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of love bring us back to himself, forgive us our sins, and assure us of his eternal love in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now the church's special prayer for today, which is the seventh Sunday after Trinity. Lord of all power and might, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your name. Increase in us true religion. Nourish us with all goodness. And of your great mercy, keep us in the same. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Psalm 100 says, shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. God is a great and mighty God. He longs for us to spend time with him. Let's just take a few minutes now to come near to God and use some songs to help us to express our thoughts and feelings for him. We're not allowed to sing together at the moment, but we can sing with gusto in our own homes. But if you prefer to just listen, that's fine too. Let's start with What a Faithful God.
Lord, I come before your throne.
Lord, I come before your throne of grace. I find rest in your presence and fullness of joy. In worship and wonder I behold your face, singing what a faith.
My song in the night, in the shelter of
sovereign, granting peace from heaven. Let me comfort those who suffer with the comfort you have given. And I will tell of your great love for as long as I live. Bye.
Now we're going to have our creed. So, let's declare our shared faith in God.
We believe in God the Father,
from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named.
We believe in God the Son,
who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We're going to have our reading now, which will be read by Penny Lewis, and then we'll have the sermon from Mark. So over to Penny for the reading. Thank you, Penny.
God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice. The earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see what the Lord has done, the desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress.
I wonder what your image of stillness is. I love to come into this space, into this church building, by myself, when no one else is here, there's no planned worship, and to just be still and pray, and praying without many words. I wonder what your image of stillness is. Maybe it's getting away from it all and lying on a beach at peace, or walking through a quiet garden, or being up early before everyone else, before the pressure and busyness of the day. I love those times, but they can be rare. Often these things are how we perceive that we connect with God, how we expect to pray and be with Him, to taking a break from the busyness of life so that we can hear him afresh, walking in nature and seeing the wonder of what God has made, the stillness of the early morning. I wonder what you've learned during lockdown. The experience has been different for each one of us, and as Wes said early on, we are all in the same storm, but we're not all in the same boat. But I know that for many, there has been a rediscovery of silence and solitude. Two key disciplines in our walk with Jesus, in our spiritual life. And for many people, the book by John Mark Comer, The Ruthless Elimination of Hurry, has been incredibly helpful. And I know that for some as well, the daily prayer app, Lectio 365 from 24/7 Prayer, has also been incredibly helpful for helping us to slow down, to be still, and to connect afresh with God. All of those things are good, and I delight in them, and I hope that you do too. But they are not what this psalm is about. When I was at Bible college, every Wednesday morning used to be a quiet morning. They would start us off in the college chapel and we'd have a little bit of teaching and then we'd be sent off in silence. And everything within me would be leaping and bursting, just wanting to talk to someone and make a noise or move. The last thing that I wanted to do was to sit in silence. It's something that I've kicked against, but over time, I found it to be helpful. I found it to be a place of reconnection with the living God for me. We are all wired differently and we all have different personalities. Some of us crave stillness and time alone. Others just want the conversations to be on all the time and to be with people all the time. For others, if you're not doing, then you're not really living. But this psalm is not about any of those things. We all have our go-to places, things that help us to follow Jesus. And these things are genuinely helpful. But God can speak to us in so many ways. For me personally, I love the discipline of thanksgiving, of practicing being thankful. And I find it helps me to see God at work. I also love to worship in song, to express how glorious and amazing God is, to declare the wonder of what he's done and my response to him in that. But I'm also in the habit of taking long walks by myself. A time to pray, but without many words. A time of just being and abiding in him and being still. It's something I've had to learn how to do. But this psalm is not about any of those things. At All Saints, our usual pattern of worship, obviously not in lockdown, is that we start the day with sanctuary. A quieter service that includes liturgy. And then we have Engage, a more informal service with band-led worship and work for the children and for our young people. And then we have Encounter, an extended time of worship and prayer and teaching, led again by the band. And we also have different expressions of prayer and ways of gathering during the week. And none of these are any better than any other. You do not graduate as a Christian from the morning worship to the evening worship, or the evening worship to the morning worship. But my hope and my prayer in each of them, whatever the style, is that we meet with the living God in the power of the Holy Spirit. And that as we follow his ways, we are transformed into his likeness, and we go into the world to share the good news of Jesus and to make a difference in the world. This is my expectation and my hope, however we worship. We can't gather in these ways at the moment. And even in September, I expect that things will continue to be different. But this psalm is not about our usual patterns of worship. It says, be still. But it's not about liturgy or about contemplation or about modern worship songs or even about quiet times. I first bumped into this psalm on the evening of the 7/7 bombings that happened in London. I was working in Canterbury at the time, and many of the members of our church worked in London. We gathered that evening to pray, not knowing if people that we loved had lost their lives. And someone read this psalm, Psalm 46. God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in times of trouble. You see, this psalm is not about our worship or our prayer styles. It's not about our quiet time. The stillness is not the stillness and the solitude of a marvelous beach holiday or a garden or even a day walking. This psalm is written in the middle of the storm. The trouble, the waters are roaring, the mountains are falling and quaking. Everything is being shaken. But even in the midst of this context, in the middle of the storm, there we can find refuge in the heart of God. He is ever present with us, our strength and our help in times of trouble. In early March in this country, we had not really clocked what was going on with coronavirus, and we certainly did not have an idea of what was about to happen. Coronavirus was really just an academic idea that was happening somewhere else as far as the general population was concerned, and there were just under 100 cases in the UK. But then the storm came, and now the death toll stands at over 45,000 confirmed cases. When the storms of life come, how do we respond? How do I respond? What's your go-to place? This answer doesn't need to be holy or righteous. It doesn't need to be the right answer. If it is, that's amazing and wonderful. But one of the reasons why the Bible talks so often about fear and worry and anxiety is because we are fearful. We do worry, and we do, me included, get anxious. To be still in the storm is not to be fear-free, but it is to be looking to the one who frees us from fear. It is not to be without worry, but it is to seek first the one who provides for us. It is not to be anxiety-free, but it is to look to the living God, to allow him to search us and to know us and to lead us in the way that is everlasting. As followers of the way of Jesus, we can't expect life to be storm-free. And these storms will bring with them fear and worry and anxiety. But if we look to Jesus, look to Jesus, the one who was able to sleep through the storm, then we will find refuge in him in the midst of the storm. Then we will rediscover stillness in the midst of the storm. And in doing so, we will know afresh who he is and who we are. Let me pray. Father God, you know the storms that each one of us face. Help us to turn our faces to you, to seek refuge in you in the midst of the storm, to allow you to be with us, to allow you to strengthen us, that we would know and trust that you are God. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen.
Thank you so much, Mark. In response to what we've heard, let's sing Be Still and Know, or if you prefer, you can just listen to the music. And then after that, Robert's going to lead us in our prayers.
Be still and know. Let's pray. The psalm says, "Be still and know that I am God." Lord, you are our refuge and strength. You are always with us in times of trouble. Therefore, we will not live in fear. Lord, we thank and praise you that you, our Creator, are in control over all the powerful people, the organizations, companies, and countries of the world. We pray for the United Nations working for peace, justice, health and safety, for Secretary General Antonio Guterres. In our nation, we pray for good leadership, wise counsel and diplomatic talent to bring us safely through the many trials we face. In our city, we pray for protection for those delivering essential services and for wisdom for our councillors. We pray especially for our hospital and community health workers. Give them the coordinated support they need to work safely and effectively, we pray. For our church, Lord Jesus, bless richly Mark and Megan, our wardens and readers. We thank you for our leadership team and volunteers who are keeping our church and community life going and beginning to reopen meetings in our church building. We pray that those in need will feel welcome at the Welcome Cafe and Food Club on Mondays. Lord Jesus, bless those planning the virtual holiday club. And please bring your healing to those who are unwell in our community. John Gilmore, Judith Leach, Adeline Thomas, Rod Fowler, and Belinda's cousin James. We bring all these things together, Lord Jesus, in your name. Amen.
Thanks, Robert. And now we're going to sing our final hymn, which is taken directly from Psalm 46. God is our strength and refuge. Finish our service with a prayer of blessing. May the love of the Lord Jesus draw us to himself. The power of the Lord Jesus strengthen us in his service. The joy of the Lord Jesus fill our hearts. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always.
Amen.
Thank you so much for joining with us in our sanctuary service this morning. I do hope that you were able to meet with God today. I'm going to leave you with the song Still from Hillsongs. It says, "When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God." I do hope that all of us manage to find some time to be still with God this week. Have a great week. I hope that we'll see each other before too long. Bye-bye for now.
I and rest my soul in Christ alone. Know His power in quietness and trust when the oceans rise and fall. I will soar with.